you're not just telling people about x-rays. X-rays are amazing.
Well, I'm Andy Stone.
Ultrasound, isn't that kind of cool?
I'm a senior leader of interdisciplinary curriculum at the Australian Science and Maths School. The ASMS is located on the Flinders University campus in Adelaide, South Australia.
You're trying to persuade the audience, kind of me, as the Minister for Health tomorrow, that your technology should be kept being funded.
The body in question central study, the overriding focus or the fertile question of the central study is how can I act to improve human health?
I'll show you my x-rays in a minute for my broken bones. Okay, they help find broken bones. That's one thing x-rays are really, really good at.
At any one time, there's only working in three central studies. We address aspects of science, we address aspects of history and English and philosophy. Within the science, we're doing bits of biology, bits of chemistry, bits of physics.
Using numbers, facts, figures, evidence, graphs. All right, so come over here.
So we've looked at sensors and the physics of waves and those sort of things.
So this is my right leg.
What we want our students to look at is an application of this understanding. So how does this understanding of the science principles, why does it matter to me or to them or society or Adelaide or the state? What if that medical imaging technology couldn't occur? Like, what would the impact be on my life? And that's where the richness comes in, is the connections between the disciplines.
What's happening here?
The bone is regrowing.
The bone is regrowing?
I guess the fertile question is the foundation on the underlying principles of the central study.
The density.
It's not as hard.
It's not as hard?
So it's going to be something that the students grapple with this continuously over 18 weeks.
Why? What makes you think that it's not an x-ray?
In this context, the answer to the fertile question could be this sort of thing. So it needs to be rich enough to sustain an interdisciplinary curriculum over a number of weeks.
Who's divided up the tasks or something along those lines? That's the stuff that needs to be in your scrapbook. Okay, some people did that really well for their investigation and it looks good. Okay, it's what we want to see. It's that planning and thinking.
Big global problems, recycling or speed limits, like they're not a physics problem or a chemistry problem or a political problem, they're everything kind of mixed together.
Should I put stuff about like how it can check the age and position of the fetus? Oh, because like if I
put the age and the gender.
Okay, MRI.
I actually had an MRI when I was younger. I kind of looked into it before doing it.
I'm doing the science behind it.
And now it's kind of just all going together and putting in a PowerPoint kind of thing.
Okay.
My role is, I guess, to help the teachers come up with these are the topics we're going to work on.
Cochlear implants.
If we don't have that big idea, then we have, well, this is a really cool activity, this is what we did last year, and this is what I usually do with my classes. Like, that's a poor justification. Like, if we can say, does it help the student answer the federal question? Yes, well, it's in, and if no, then see you later.
So essentially, can you summarise how it works in two sentences?
Kind of. I'll find it.
And you can't have the connections between disciplines if we don't address the disciplines themselves.
Unlike X-ray, for instance, there's no long-term damage. It's just sound.
Yeah.
Not sending in ionising radiation.
I think an inspirational teacher can make the learning relevant. An inspirational teacher makes students want to understand, not just know. Generates in the students a desire or a passion to want to learn themselves. To make those connections, you need to get those teachers working together. So a willingness to work with other teachers, to share ideas and to collaboratively develop materials.
Next week we start the health topics.
You can't get slack, you can't get lazy, because you've got another six teachers who are going to be working on that lesson, who are going to be picking up the best things.
Of places to find your information.
See you tomorrow for our last lesson.
So if we have these interdisciplinary central studies, we can have a really strong application to the real world and make the learning meaningful for students.